I can just simply die. I need a reason to die. But death is not after all. For the reason, I found it. It is midnight. When I have finished this letter, I shall kill myself. You will be proud of your son now.
Cahyo, why did you work so late? You look so tired. Is there anything I should do to help you?
You are being promoted to be a managing director. Aren't you happy?
Yes, I'm happy.
I officially promote you to be managing director at Korea Television. Yahyo Aji Pamungkas.
Thank you so much, Mrs. Lydia.
This is your report. Good luck.
Thank you. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
See other teachers of my life. If I restore it all over again, will it free me from this burden? each night. This and other things disgust me and make me sick of living this. I think I have to take this day off and go out. Please can make me feel better. Also, this place is crowded. It leaves me nothing but loneliness. Also, this place is colorful. But the only color remains is black.
Thank you. doctor?
Thank you.
course. Yes, come in.
Afternoon, sir.
Oh, sorry, good afternoon. Yes, sir, please.
Can you sign this report, sir?
Yes, come in.
Sir, our clients were worried about your accent today, so they want to meet you at 1 PM, sir.
Thank you, Mike Cannon.
What, sir?
Sorry, my head is bleeding right now. Could you please just leave me alone?
Yes.
Please.
I apologize. Afternoon, sir.
Oh. Okay, afternoon, please sit down.
Yes. Sir, I'm sorry because Mr. Sahil can't meet you today. He has many agenda, sir. How about next week?
Next week?
Yes.
Okay, maybe you can remind me about the meeting for the next week. And send me my gratitude for Mr. Sahil.
Okay, I'm so sorry, sir.
Okay, no problem.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay, you're welcome.
For a long time, I've been thinking of clearing up this drawer. I cherish my life. I will never disturb this burial place of old letters again. Thank you. where I close my eyes, never read the word again, so that I will never recognize some forgotten handwriting which blank me suddenly into the sea of memories.
Dear my friend Cahil, how are you my dear friend? I hope you are fine. It has been a long time I didn't write a letter for you, and perhaps it will be my last one. I received your letter, thanks a million for writing, and I'm sorry for being very late to reply your letter. God might have another plan. I was hospitalized, it is going worse and worse. Every single day, you know, every time I felt this pain, I tried to forget it by reminiscing our memories when we were college students.
Hey, buddy.
Hey.
How's your fight?
What is that? It was really bad. The lecturers, they say no.
No? No, that's wrong. You are the best student I ever knew.
So you are.
I know you can break your limit. Don't worry. Just do what you can do. And let God solve the rest. I will always help you.
Thanks, buddy. You're right.
I'm glad you got a new position in your company as chief administration. I know you are capable to fill that position. I remember when we were a college student, I ever taught you about falling is not the end of your life. You can do any other things and enjoy your lives. Take care, your dearest friend, Chandra.
Dear Jahyo, having a son like you was the greatest gift. You are all I have. As the hours tick, you have become a man, an intelligent and wise man. I know that you are on the last hours of your study. I hope that you could finish your study soon. You rarely called me recently. I know that you are busy with your study, but please come home occasionally. 2 years, you didn't come home. Please drop by for a day. I just want to see your face and talk to you directly. That will heal my loneliness.
Thank you.
understand I'm fine. You will be on shoulder all your life.
Clearly remember the stuff I put inside this. It's still the same. Everything is the same as before. A red rose. Even being very red, and I'm being older. It has been a long time I've been saving this thing. The look changed, but the feel is still the same. The one and only thing that attracts my attention.
Both of us are always here,
watching the same news, enjoying the same view,
and inhaling the same air.
Yes, always the same view.
I know, dear. You always do what you always do. I know.
It is always between you day after day.
This life, dear.
If you could, you can do anything in a different way.
If I could.
I believe you could do so, and your bright eyes, it will say something that
Fill your mouth hot till your heart stops to beat.
You know me very well, as always. This brooch is for you. This is my mother's. Put it on your face.
Thank you, I will. This brooch will always be in my heart. Like you, you are always in my heart.
Yes, dear. I will read this book for you tonight because this is your day.
Thank you.
Make way, please. I heard he was a managing director.
But it seems he could not manage his own affair.
Now it's your turn to manage him. Make sure you leave no single thing. He is in capable hands. Wait a minute, I'll go upstairs.
He's in a illness, he's crying. He's in perfect shape.
He might have a day. Or somebody has given him a hard day.
My dear.
That's our job, to find it. Let's go inside and check the office.
Yes, sir.
It is midnight. When I have finished this letter, I shall kill myself. Why? I shall attempt to give the reasons, not for those who may read this lens, but for myself, to kindle my warning courage, to impress upon myself the fatal necessity of this act, which can, at best, be only deferred. I was brought up by simple-minded parents who were unquestioning believers, and I believed as they did. My dream lasted a long time. The last veil has just been torn from my ears. During the last few years, a strange change has been taking place within me. All the events of life, which formerly had to me glow of a beautiful sunset, are now fading away. The true meaning of things had appeared to me in its brutal reality. And true reason for love has disgusted me. Even for this poetic sentiment, we, on the eternal ties of foolish and charming illusions which are always being renewed. Formerly, I was happy. Everything pleased me. The passing women, the appearance of the streets, the place where I live, and I even took an interest in my cut of my clothes. But the repetition of the same sight has had the result of filling my heart with weariness and disgust. But The repetition of the same sight has had the result of filling my heart with weariness and disgust. Just one would feel would want to go every night to the same theater. For the last 30 years, I have been rising at the same hour and at the same restaurant. I have been eating at the same hour, the same dishes brought me by different waiters. I have tried travel. The loneliness which one feels in strange places terrified me. I felt so alone, so small on the earth, that I quickly started on my homeward journey. And here, the unchanging expression of my furniture, which has stood for 30 years in the same places. The smell of my room each night, this and other things disgust me and make me sick of living this. Each day, when I save, and hear the unchanging expression of my furniture, which has stood for 30 years in the same places. The smell of my room each night, this and other things disgust me and make me sick of living this. Each day, when I shave, I feel ordinary desire to cut my throat and my face, which I see in the mirror. Always the same, with chalk on my cheeks, made me weep from sadness. It is all over. I had gone back to the beginning. The top of this place is the last stand of me. Never reread your outlets.
And that is how many men come to kill themselves, and we search in vain to discover some great sorrow in their life.
When I went to